Today I am going to talk to you about the Tourette's Survival Kit, tools for young adults with tics. I really enjoyed this book, and I haven't been sent before many books around Tourette's and tics, so I don't know if that's that there isn't much out there, which I suspect is possibly the case, or maybe just hasn't entered my radar so much. Anyhow, I haven't known what to recommend in the past. I now have a good new recommendation. So this is a new book by Tara Murphy and Damon Miller. So Damon is the designer, so the book has got images throughout, which are great. And then Tara, so she is a consultant clinical psychologist. I'm going to read this out because she's like proper impressive. Consultant clinical psychologist and pediatric neuropsychologist, following, involved in research at the Tic Disorder Clinic at Great Ormond Street Hospital in London. So she kind of knows what she's doing, basically, I think is the long and the short of that. So yeah, Great Ormond Street Hospital, like any work I've ever done with them, I've always had such utmost respect for the people there because they are like the world leading experts in their field. So we can be pretty confident in the content. Now the book is directly aimed at young people who have got Tourette's, and it's basically like a how-to guide for life if you have Tourette's, which I love. And it goes through like all the different situations that you might encounter, from like getting on a bus to doing exams to being in a relationship to whatever you can imagine, and it just gives you advice from other young people with Tourette's about what you might be able to do in that situation. So it's basically split into kind of two parts of the book. You basically got bits about situation, so there's a special logo for that, and you kind of see this throughout the book. So can you see? Yeah, you can see there, it's like the situation symbol, and then we've also got like the little span, which is about like the tools, get it, spanner tools, so what to do. So this is like about skills building. So like much of the book is about different situations and what we do, but then towards the back we've got more like the tools section, and that's like, yeah, what can we do to help ourselves. And then there's bits at the back which is like for other people, but yeah, I'm less interested in that bit because I'm the young person with Tourette's. If I'm reading this book, I'm not so worried about other people. Maybe. Anyhow, so you've got your situation, you've got your tools. Oh yeah, and then the other thing is that basically like the book is full of advice from all these other young people who've got Tourette's, as well as directly from Tara and like other members of the team. And so at the beginning you've got these kind of like little biogs about who they are. So example here, Eliza. Hi, I'm Eliza. I'm 15 years old and have had tics since I was 4. I used to be bothered by the tics, but once I realised that the tics were not that important, I stopped caring about them so much. Now I'm the boss. So you get advice from Eliza and other people like her throughout the book. So that's quite cool. Okay, so I'm going to show you a few different bits from the book to give you a bit of an idea of what it's like, because that's what I do, because you know me, I love to follow a formula. So here's an example. So I'm going to look now at pages 27 onwards, and we're looking here about what happens at exams. So it's saying tics needn't be a really big problem in exams so long as you find a way to accommodate them. So this is like then from the point of view of the person with the tics. I need to focus on my exams, everyone else needs to focus too, that's not easy when I'm ticking, what can I do? And then you've got advice that is based from 1 month before, 1 week before, tomorrow and today, from like both the professionals and the young people themselves. So for example, Harry says, find a space for ticking before and after the exam, find places where you'll be able to tick without anyone being distracted, make sure that the places are close enough to reach quickly. So like really practical advice, like I've got an exam, I'm worried about it, actually knowing there's somewhere I can go before and after to kind of get the ticking out of my system, great advice. Like really simple but really really good advice. Simple, practical, actionable advice, which is exactly the kind of advice we all need all the time, right? So yeah, love it. Okay, another example I liked was going on a first date. So a first date makes me nervous, neither of us knows what to expect, will we click or not? Tics can increase that nervousness and nervousness can increase tics. Ah, what can I do to stop feeling so nervous and ticky? Suggestions then. So Zach says, practice suppression, you only really need to hold your tics in for a few minutes for the first impression, so practice the tic suppression tools at the back until you can get good enough that your date can see you smile comfortably. There's no point holding tics in if it makes you grimace and squirm with the effort. So that's in, you know, you then look in the tools bit and it's like living with tics, how to suppress temporarily until you get past that first bit. This is basically trying to take as much of the anxiety out of the situation as possible, because the more anxious you are, the more likely you are to tick. And so they're giving you really good clear advice on how to be less anxious. I mean, lots of this good advice for life, period, for young people. But yes, coming from people who have this lived experience too. And then I also wanted to highlight page 161, which is in the like tools section. And this is about being more than my tics. And I thought this was really important. So what can you do to avoid being thought of just as that person with Tourette's? Normalize things quickly, ensure people see normal conversation and interaction, not just tics when they meet you. Again, simple, super stuff. So yeah, love it. What are the three things that I most liked about this book? Number one, I think, would be the style. Like, I love it. The illustrations are brilliant. They're kind of like almost sort of manga type style, and it's cool. I think that a kid who had Tourette's would not be ashamed to be seen with this book. I think they would kind of identify with it and think someone's written something actually pretty neat for me, which I think is cool. Number two, I love the fact that so many different situations are covered under like school and love and home and all the different things. So you've got a kind of how-to for like a whole range of different scenarios that you can turn straight to if you're a young person facing a new situation. And I think just being able to do that, which would remove some of the anxiety around whatever that situation is, will automatically mean that you're probably going to be able to manage your Tourette's a bit better, because it seems that anxiety is a really key thing to keep control of. So I love that. Yeah, huge range of situations, and they don't shy away from any of the tough stuff. And then finally, like, I really like that it's done with a bit of a sense of humour. So on page 155 here, I don't know, there's something about the way in which the images are done that feels really sort of lighthearted, and sometimes it's a little bit sort of tongue-in-cheek, and I don't know, it's not all serious. It's kind of a bit fun, and sometimes acknowledges a little bit of kind of dark humour around Tourette's, like a bit of an in-joke every now and then. Just tries not to make it like this big, scary, horrible thing, but rather kind of, this is something we can manage together. So there we go. I'd recommend it either for a young person, or if you are supporting someone who has Tourette's, then there are some really good practical ideas in here that you could use to kind of suggest to them too. But really, this is aimed for them. Get them a copy, let them use it themselves, maybe discuss it with them. But yeah, great, great Bible really for any kid with Tourette's, would recommend. Hope it was a helpful review. Do let me know in the comments below if there are any books or resources you would like to see me review in future videos. And please subscribe so that you will see new videos on Tuesdays and Fridays moving forwards. And I'll see you next time. Thank you. Bye.